Students, good morning once again. I am here again for you to give the next series, that is the second part of the chapter Determiners. But before that, let me remind you what you have learned about the determiners in the previous video. So you can just remember that we have learned that all articles are determiners. I repeat, all articles are determiners. It means that all determiners are not articles. It is not necessary. It means that there are certain determiners which are not articles. It means, again, apart from articles, there are many other kinds of determiners. And this is what we are going to discuss and understand in part 2 of this series of videos on determiners. So without wasting time, let us go straight to the video. And here we go. At the outset, it is important to know the objectives of this video. We will begin with recapitulation, and then at the end of this particular video, you will be able to develop the ability of listing all the determiners and classifying them. Students, we will begin by recapitulation. What we have learned in the previous video? Number one, that all articles are not determiners. Okay? It means that there are some articles, there are some determiners which are not articles. What are they? We'll come to know through analysis of some examples that is seen directly on your screen. Here you can see that there are two groups of sentences. On the top there are 5 sentences, and at towards the bottom there are 10 sentences. The bottom side sentences are the examples that were given as test or practice test to you in the previous video. We will analyze these sentences. Now let us begin by analyzing the top 5 sentences. Number 1. The boy was very intelligent. The boy was very intelligent. Here the noun word is boy, and it is preceded by the word the. As you know, it's an article and it is preceding a noun, therefore it's a determiner. It has been underlined as D and N respectively. A few apples of this basket are rotten. Here, few apples is a noun phrase and basket is a noun. Therefore, a and this, they too can be designated or are designated as determiners. Third sentence. His father is going to America next month. In this example, father is noun and it is preceded by his, which has been marked as D, that is determiner. And again, month is marked as N, that is noun, and the word preceding is next is a determiner and is marked as T. The question is, America, the word America is also noun. So why not take 2 as a determiner? Yes, that's a good question that is coming up in your mind, but we will answer this question and we will be able to understand this at the end of this lesson. Fourth sentence is, all these organs are mine. Here, organs is a noun and these is D2 is second determiner and all is D1 is a first determiner. So there are 2 determiners used here. Fifth sentence, each boy has a pen. Here each is a determiner, R is a determiner, and boy and pen are nouns. Now coming to the bottom portion of the 10 examples which I gave you as a practice test in the previous video, let us analyze that. And you may cross-check it with your answer which you have done. Here R is a determiner and man is noun. 2 is a determiner and hands is noun. Either is a determiner, street is noun, whose is determiner, book is noun, this is the determiner, pen is noun, that is a determiner, again pen is noun. In the fifth sentence, my is a determiner, which precedes the noun grandfather, R is a determiner, which precedes the noun teacher. English is noun, but off has not been designated as a determiner. You will come to know at the end of this lesson. In the sixth sentence, new book is a noun phrase, which is preceded by her. It's a determiner. In the seventh sentence, men is a noun. All that precedes this noun is a determiner, marked as T. In the 8th sentence, a bottle of milk. Here, bottle is noun, which is preceded by a, which is a determiner. Milk is noun. It's preceded by a preposition of, but it's not a determiner. In the 9th sentence, half of the milk has been consumed. Here, milk is noun, which is preceded by the, it's a determiner, and it is also preceded by HALF, half, which is again a determiner. So there are two determiners used before the noun milk. And in the last sentence, that is the 10th sentence, we see that a large number of money has been spent. Here, a large amount of money. Large amount is a noun phrase and it is preceded by article of, which is a determiner. Otherwise, in other way, you can also understand in this way that a large amount of is a determiner which is used before the noun money. So, my question is, out of so many determiners which have been underlined, some are articles. Can you find out what the other types of determiners are?
But let's wait for some time. Now coming to the next set of sentences, which is from 11 to 20, which is shown just before your screen, on your screen. Let us analyze these sentences. Again, these are the sentences that have been given as a practice test to you, so you can take it as a solution of those questions. 11, sentence number 11. They bought some sugar and some apples. Here, there are some before sugar and some before apples. These two are determiners. There are 20 students in my class. In this sentence, students is a noun preceded by 20, which is a determiner. Class is a noun preceded by my, which is a determiner. Each boy in the class has a dictionary. Here there are three nouns: boy, class, and dictionary. And they are preceded by three words each: the, and a. All these three are determiners. Do you have any problem? Here, problem is a noun, and any which precedes the noun is a determiner. 15 number sentence. Several students are absent today. Here, students is a noun, and several has been marked as a determiner which precedes this noun. You may again recollect that a determiner is a word or a group of words that is used just before a noun or a noun phrase, or a determiner precedes a noun. So here's again number 16. Both boys are intelligent and laborious. In this example, boys is noun and both is a determiner used before this noun. 17th, that pen is mine. Pen is a noun which is preceded by that which is a determiner. 18th sentence, he has not any house to live in. Here a house is noun and any precedes this noun, it's a determiner. And 19th sentence, I go there twice a week. Here week is noun and there are two determiners, twice marked as T1 and a marked as T2. They both precede the noun week. And the last sentence, you see money and work, there are two nouns. Money is preceded by mo, which is marked as T, that's a determiner. And work is preceded by a group of words, a lot of, which is a determiner. So, if you have checked it, you have probably found your mistakes. Yes, the mistakes, I guess, could be in the sentences. Sentence number 3, sentence number 5, and sentence number 8. Because in these sentences, you have also underlined certain words that are nouns, but probably you have underlined the word preceding these nouns as determiners. But unfortunately, these are not determiners because they are most they are prepositions. So we can say that prepositions cannot be called a determiner. Definitely, prepositions cannot be a determiner. Now question is, what are the determiners used? Probably you have listed all the determiners. Check it out. At the bottom side, I have given a list of the list of determiners that have been used here, and they have been classified. You see, and the, these are articles. Number two, either, both, each, and all. They are all adjective of number. Number three, whose, which, and what. They are interrogative adjectives. This, that, they are demonstrative adjectives. My and her, they are possessive adjectives. And any, several, a lot of, they are adjectives of quantity. And half, 20, twice, these are adjectives of numbers. Yes, I think you have guessed it right. Can you see what are determiners made of? Or what parts of a speech are determiners?